What's going on, everybody? Jan's Anson back again for another video, and if you've read the title, yes, I overdosed in Japan. Long story, but let's get into it, shall we? So if you guys don't know, I've been in Japan for one whole month, and it has been not as exciting as some of you may or may not think about. Obviously, when you come on a holiday to another country or a vacation, if you're American, you're obviously going to do a plethora of things and go and see so many sights. So in my 1 month review of being here, it is very much somewhat a little bit boring because you pretty much have to, you know, go to City Hall, get your residency, get a phone number, get a bank, all that sort of stuff. So you're not really focusing on like going out and doing some amazing things at every opportunity you can. Now, while my first few weeks of being here has been quite busy to say the least, unfortunately, around about the third week, slightly after Halloween, which was an all right night, somewhat, maybe. I didn't really have the Shibuya meltdown experience because they were very manageable with Halloween this year, especially with all like the promotions and the funding that they did going into making sure that, you know, it wasn't as hectic as you may see from pictures online. And I think it is because of that I got a little bit sick, whether it was the common cold or whether it was influenza. Who really knows what really happened with my illness, but I got really, really sick, to which it was something I kind of expected was going to happen anyway, because every time I go on holiday or a vacation, I always seem to get sick. And especially with Japan's constant changing of the seasons or weather, which, to be honest, is still relatively warm, but there was definitely a shift within maybe humidity where the air got a bit more colder or a bit more drier, you know, your body needs to adjust and things happen. So during my sickness, I actually went to go take, you know, some, you know, painkillers, stuff like that, or flu medicine, as you would. Now, I still was sick after taking the medication, so I went to go essentially get more. I looked up online what was like the best recommended, I guess you could say, flu medicines there was, and there was two things that was recommended, and one was this, which is like a really strong, like three tablets thing, where you had to take like three tablets like every 4 hours, 6 hours, something like that. And then I also got this thing, which was probably my biggest mistake ever, which was a cough syrup medicine, which, because I had a very bad sore throat and it was really on fire. But except that this isn't a cough medicine per se, it is a cough suppressant, I believe. And here's where the problem underlyingly happened. Because while I was taking a lot of the cold and flu medicines, I was actually mixing it with this, which is an opioid, which is very, very fucking strong. And because of my ignorance to language or being a bit careless, I overdosed a lot on the opioid and with the flu medicine, which had like at least close to 2000 milligrams of like ibuprofen and painkillers and whatever else was in there, throwing the opioids into the mix, and it completely fucked me up, to say it in the most politest terms. So if you saw on Twitter, I actually said that I was experiencing panic attacks, and for like 3 to 4 days, even close to a week, there was a point where I couldn't sleep, and there was a point where like I couldn't sleep because my whole body was just incomplete, the shakes, I was, you know, throwing up, I couldn't really eat food because the thought of food made me want to heave, and I was in just so much pain and so much stress and like whatever panic attack, which I do think they were panic attacks. I think whatever doubts in my head that I had from moving here and the loneliness from being here was accelerated by the drugs that I was taking. So that anxiety that I had built up, or that panic that I had just arose to the surface. And even though I logically in my head knew kind of what I needed to do, especially to earn money, and especially like, oh, I needed to do videos to earn some more money so I can keep on top of things, and you know, I guess the overall worry of not being able to make it here for a year, I think just made things really implode for me, and probably made my panic attacks way worse than what they would have probably would have been. Maybe it would have happened for like a day or two instead of like a fucking week, who knows. So I guess the moral of the story is, if you do come to stay here, one, do not take medication more than you usually would, because in the UK, I have a rough idea of how much medication I would take for like a headache or like a flu. But here, I kind of didn't or don't, because I don't know the brands and whatnot, and I can read partially what some things may or may not say. So I messed up in that regard. But yeah, as things have been here, it has been quite a interesting time, and it is quite expensive. And it is quite expensive, and it's not expensive to live here. That is not primarily the issue. It was expensive to move everything here, right? The deposit, you know, obviously paying two deposits, or sorry, well, the rent and the deposit, and then obviously the flight here, which of course with all the world tragedies going on and the wars going on, the flight prices have risen through the roof. And then of course the PC that I bought over wasn't cheap to ship over either. And then of course the Royal Mail, which I love you, the UK. Even when I get out of the country, you still find ways to really clap my cheeks. So I had to repair the PC, which left me without a PC for 2 weeks. So there's multiple different things that caused me to lose quite a lot of money within quite a vast amount of time. So that didn't really help my mental health whatsoever. And getting a job here is also quite difficult as well, because even though I understood that like 95% of jobs here are English teaching jobs, and I don't have a bachelor's degree, it's not really something the UK really promotes or really pushes you to do per se. I don't personally think so anyway, is that you need a bachelor's degree to get a English teaching job, which is 95% of the jobs that you'll see on most websites. And then the rest of the jobs, they expect you to have somewhat some sort of conversational Japanese, to which, again, I don't really have. I have maybe N5 at the very most, which, again, I never really passed the M5 because I did like a mock test online, and though I could understand the context of what N5 was asking me, so when I could read the questions, I could bullet point keywords and then kind of suggest or understand what it's asking me to give the correct answer. I could probably pass M5 if I really wanted to, and I probably will at some point, but because I haven't done a proper test, I can basically just do survival Japanese, right? Which is how to introduce myself, speak in very simple sentences, but I'm more of a reader than a speaker, so I somewhat understand more keywords or key phrases more so than that. So the job market is extremely limited to those that can't speak conversational Japanese and don't have a degree, basically. So I hadn't had the best mental gymnastic when it came to my panic attack. And even now, I feel like even though it's still a struggle, I can still make it work. And I think, you know, these things should be expected, because when you look at YouTube and you see other people that have moved here, they already have like either an English teaching job already signed up for them, or they'll do some odd jobs here and there because they've saved up so much money from like mommy or daddy, or they've saved up a good amount. But a lot of people also live in like share homes too, which is extremely cheap. But I didn't want to live in a share home because I wanted to obviously have my own space, but also like do YouTube videos without someone like banging on the door and being like, shut the fuck up. So, you know, I guess that's the price you pay, right? But again, I think this is just like an update, right? This is what it's like to live in Japan for a month if you are coming here on a working holiday visa and you are here to potentially go and pursue that type of goal or set that out for yourself. I think the one thing I will recommend is that if you take away the flights and your first month's deposit and rent away from the equation, I would suggest maybe about 10 grand in terms of like where you get to at least do half a year to maybe a year, depending on how you budget, the thought of not worrying about finances. Because yeah, you can eat. It all depends on where you live, right? Because my apartment doesn't really have a fridge. It's a very small beer fridge type thing, and I have a little bit of cupboard space for maybe some dry foods. But realistically, like, I can't really cook, I can't really do anything like that, so I do have to go out and eat. And obviously, you know, $5 or £5 to $10 to £10 does add up every single day. So maybe I would suggest thinking about those things too. But I also want to say that yes, I will continue to do some more updates, and I will continue to be more active on YouTube now. Now that I've kind of gotten over my, you know, anxiety and panic attacks and whatnot. But I thought it was also important to give you guys an update on what it's kind of like here to come here for a month. And maybe you may have a better time, or maybe you could go through the same thing that I did. Who really knows? But yes, some exciting things anyway. Jump Festa is around the corner for December, which I will be going to. I do need to pre-order myself that, but I also have the tickets, which I got from my 7-Eleven, because apparently that's how you do it. You order tickets and then you have to go to 7-Eleven to go pick them up. But there you go, there's my ticket for the Bleach Exposition. So I will be going for that. I'll try and take pictures, I'll try and take video, and maybe try and do a video on it. But again, Japan is quite strict with recording in exhibits, so I'll see what I can work with and get away with. But other than that, you know, end of the year's coming. There's going to be some big news, some big stuff, events going on in Japan in general. So I will try to cover as much as I can, as much as I physically can, because also I get very nervous with recording outside because I don't want to make myself look like the average foreigner. That's kind of cringy. But that's my update anyway. I overdosed without the high. I think that's the worst thing about it, is that like I overdosed and I didn't even get a high from it, but I got the downward like withdrawals from it. So I got the worst. I got the worst deal when it came to drugs. But anyway, with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Be handsome as always, people. Peace out.